Most of the world's largest enterprises are still using mainframes today. Learn how you can use data virtualization to access that data from places like Power BI this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by two special members from the Azure Core Specialized Workloads team, Bhuvi and Jim. Thanks so much for coming on the show today. I think we'll get right into it because we have a lot of interesting things to talk about related to exposing mainframe data to Azure. And I'm not really sure what this even means. So I'd love to just kick it off and ask, like, what types of scenarios are you seeing customers have where they might want to do data virtualization from their mainframes?
Sure. Thanks for having me here, Anna. And again, to answer your question, it's a very interesting question itself, because a lot of organizations even now are having most of their golden copies of the data on the mainframe. So as per stats, 44 out of the 50 leading banks, top 10 insurance, largest retailers that you can think of, unbelievable or not, but they are still having their mainframe data. And what becomes challenging is to expose that data outside of the mainframe and integrate with the other data types that they have outside of that. It might be on cloud, it might be through their mobile apps or other deep learning or AI or other use cases that they might want to expose their mainframe data and combine it, integrate it in a more holistic fashion. So that is where this becomes a very strong product or service itself to offer.
Got it. Cool. So can you tell us a little bit more about how it works?
Yeah, sure. So let me move you on a little bit about how do you want to go around it and then how it exactly works. So like I said, there is a variety of data that's out there, and sometimes it becomes a little bit more time consuming and costly to access that data from the outside world. And what we want is quick data, not stale data, not data with latency, and we want deeper analysis of the data. So to make that happen, let me quickly take you to the architecture. So like I said, there can be many clients that would be looking for that data, and they want that data to come out of the mainframe or combine it with the mainframe data. So to do that, let's say a request comes on the mainframe. Now, the power of this solution is, which is what I'm going to talk about, is virtualizing the data on the mainframe. So to virtualize the data on the mainframe, imagine a data layer that sits on top of the data that's already on your mainframe, but it leverages a lot of data optimization and through different type of drivers that we can expose for you to get access to that data. So if you walk with me all the way to the right, you can see different data sources that reside onto the mainframe. Now, if you want to directly go from the client side onto those data sources, you'll have to go to the actual data. But in this case, what we are doing is that data that sits on the mainframe is virtualized, and through virtual views, you can get access to that data. And to optimize it even further, for example, if you have big queries, you can have that data fetched in parallel or in serialized manner through buffers. So imagine you have a query which would have essentially taken you hours, but using this solution, the time can be significantly reduced. So with all of that processing happening, the access to that data becomes very easy.
Gotcha. Super cool. Makes a lot of sense why I would want to do this. One question I have for you is, on the screen there, you have a zIIP type of server or engine. Like, what is that? And how does that help in saving costs for data virtualization?
Sure. So zIIP stands for Z Systems Integrated Information Processor. It's a mainframe specialty engine. So there are two types of engines that are on the mainframe: specialty engine and general processor engines. Now, what happens is that when you are talking to general processor, it's more costly. So the every time you make a request to the general processor, there's more cost involved. For zIIP engines, they are more cost effective, better performance, and then at the same time, they can give you results to big queries. They can even run Java or Linux. And then what happens using this particular solution running on the zIIP engines, what happens is that if the workloads are efficient enough and qualified to run on zIIP, then these requests that are coming from the client will not be routed to the general processor engines. They will be routed to the zIIP engines. And that is how you can reduce a lot of cost. Also, the software that we are talking about, it might be a software coming from IBM. It can be software coming from Rocket. And in both of these solutions, their solution or their software itself runs on zIIP engine, majority, almost 99% of that.
Okay, gotcha. So you're kind of set up to kind of get the best cost savings using this method. When it comes to this mainframe data, like how is it typically classified?
There are many categories, but at the broad level, we can call them as a structured data, semi-structured data, or operational data. So as you see on the right, structural data can be DB2, Adabas Natural, IDMS, IMS. Semi-structured is more around MQ, vSAM, or sequential data sets. But operational is all about data logging. So you can imagine things like system logs, SMF records, or tape data.
Got it. Cool. Okay. So now that we kind of understand why we want this, what the approach is, I heard there was a great demo. Jim, you want to take us through that?
Sure. Yeah. So what we have here is actually using Power BI. And one thing I also wanted to point out was this is not copying the data over from the mainframe. When you're accessing it via virtual host, you're actually accessing the data via a virtual host, or the data is virtually exposed via the virtual host back to the mainframe store. So when you're talking about vSAM data or their flat file data sources that to the mainframe look like data sources, when you write back to those data sources via virtual database, is it actually writes back to those. In this case, I'm actually showing connecting to mainframe data from Power BI. So this data right here is Power BI is read only, but when I click into different items, it actually updates using the regular Power BI functionality. But this data physically resides on the mainframe. In this case, it's actually vSAM data, but it could be DB2 data, it could be IMS data, all the other data sources that were listed in there. So this is a really simple example of using database virtualization, which is housed on the mainframe, exposing the data and using it in this case, Power BI, but it could be any other Azure source as well.
Got it. Cool. Okay. That was a super great demo. Concise. I like the simplicity of it. I always love to see Power BI, though I am not a great person at building dashboards. But you know, as we kind of close out, I'd love to get y'all's thoughts on any tips or tricks for folks who are either just getting started with this or pretty far down the road with this. Like, what advice do you have to them?
I think it's just experimenting with the tool themselves. There's a lot of information available from Rocket and also from IBM. IBM has a red book on database virtualization. They call it different things. There's Rocket Database Virtualization or Rocket Data Virtualization. And so, yeah, there's tons of information to go out there and experiment with. And that's anything you can think of, Bhuvi?
Yeah, and one thing that I would like to add on is try to understand what is the best use case for the organization. So if it is keeping the data on the mainframe, this is going to work very well. You might want to consider taking data out of the mainframe or keeping some data here, some data there. So as Jim mentioned, you have to start studying about different solutions that are available. And then this is the power of this solution is the data doesn't move. The data is in place. And on top of that, you are virtualizing the data.
Awesome. Cool. Well, thanks so much for coming on the show. Personally, I learned a lot about how to do data virtualization from Mainframes. To our viewers, I'm sure you learned a lot as well. If you like this episode, go ahead and give it a like, leave a comment, and let us know what you think or what you learned. Check the description for some information on how to learn more, and we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.